What's going on, guys? It's OmniArch, and today I want to bring you a brand new video talking about a topic that surfaced a few days ago on Twitter and on YouTube about Faze. If you guys don't know, I don't really cover drama on this channel too much, but, you know, Colossal is crazy, actually was talking shit about Faze, and he kind of got into a little Twitter beef with Faze Adapt, and, you know, Faze Blaziken, I think, like, subtweeted him or whatever, and he kind of responded to that, and it was basically just him saying, you know, Faze is becoming irrelevant, and that they make shit content, and they're making shit content because it's clickbaity, and they're trying to stay relevant in the community and get people to watch them. Now, I absolutely love Colossal is crazy. He's hilarious. I love watching his videos, and I am a fan of his, and I also am kind of a fan of Faze. You know, I don't have that much time to watch YouTube these days, so there's not that many YouTubers that I watch consistently, at least during school, you know, during the summertime and during winter break and little breaks, things like that. I do watch some videos from, you know, the OpTic members, some of the Faze members, mainly like Faze Adapt, Faze Rug, but I was curious, you know, I was thinking, maybe he's right. You know, Faze obviously has transitioned over the years from a mainly a Call of Duty sniper clan into a massive gaming entertainment organization that covers a ton of different aspects of the community. I'm pretty sure they started back in Modern Warfare 2. I'm not entirely sure. It might have been a little bit before that. But that's really when they like rose to fame, in my opinion, with the whole intervention and all the trick shots and all that stuff. And since then, you know, the whole clan has grown very, very large, and it's been effective. They obviously have a pro team now, and they have, you know, people like Faze Adapt and Faze Rug who, you know, they do trick shot and stuff, but really, it's not their channels. Aren't exclusively that content. They have definitely branched out into other things, you know, Faze Apex as well. You know, sometimes they upload even different games, like maybe it's like, oh, I'll jokingly upload Club Penguin or, you know, just random stuff like that. And, you know, that's totally fine. And, you know, it's whatever the viewers want to see. If it's entertaining to them, then totally sure, go for it. But Colossal is crazy has a point in that over the years, they've had to stray away from Call of Duty to remain relevant. You know, Call of Duty is obviously on the decline. It has been for years now, and while it's still like the biggest selling gaming franchise every year consistently, its fan base is kind of dying down in as far as, you know, it's kind of just condensing into a more core fan base, I would say. And with fewer people buying the game every year, that means fewer people are interested in watching gameplay, and in order to stay relevant, people like Faze Adapt and the entire Faze clan entertainment group has to upload newer content. With that being said, I wanted to check out the social blades of these Faze members because I was curious, you know, is he right? Are they actually becoming irrelevant? Are they actually, you know, falling off, so to speak, as far as their, you know, social networks go? You know, are they on the decline just like Call of Duty? Or, you know, I just was wondering, are they heading towards being washed up? Have they peaked already, or what's going on? But the first one I obviously want to talk about is Faze Adapt, because he was the main person who was talking to Colossal on Twitter from September 27th to October 10th. You can see every single day he consistently gets over 1,000 followers, and it actually has picked up a little bit recently, with a couple of days more recently that have been over the 2,000 follower mark. Now, unfortunately, this doesn't let us see the growth from, you know, a couple of months ago. You know, if we had a ton of data where we could see from like 6 months ago or something like that, or even maybe 2 years ago, then we'd be able to tell. But if you do look at the bottom, it says Twitter progress graphs for Faze Adapt. It's a steady uptrend. There's no signs of him slowing down. There's no signs of people unfollowing him. There's no signs of people following him at a slower rate where it's plateauing. It's pretty much straight up. And honestly, I feel like there's nothing here as far as his Twitter that says that, you know, he is becoming irrelevant or that he has fallen off. He has 1.23 million followers right now on Twitter, which is huge. He's the 2,255th most famous person on Twitter as far as followers go, and he gets over 500 retweets on average per tweet, and on average he gets about 4,000 likes per tweet. So on average, he's gaining over 1,700 people per day, and that's totally cool, and I don't think that he's falling off. Looking at Adapt's YouTube channel, we can see his subscribers are still going up at a very reasonable rate. He gets over 4,700 subs on average every single day and over 750,000 views per day. Looking at these, there's just no way to say that his channel is dying, that he's falling off, that he's becoming irrelevant. There's absolutely nothing here. You know, you can look at his total views per month and his total subs per month, and you can see, like, okay, you know, he's had a pretty steady increase in following over the years. This goes all the way back to January of 2012. So we can take a look at the total views per month and the total subs per month. And this goes actually all the way back to the beginning of 2012. And you can see just by looking at these graphs, it's been a pretty steady uptrend the entire time. Now, if you do go back the past few months, you can see that his summertime views are his highest that he's ever had this most recent summer. And then it does drop way down to 22.2 million views for the month of September, which was last month. And I actually talked about this in a previous video of mine. Views on YouTube as a whole drop off in September because most of YouTubers' viewers are younger children, you know, kids in middle school, high school, and also kids in college. And when, you know, September comes around, people start getting back into school, back into college, and people just don't have time to watch YouTube like they did. You know, maybe they'll still watch one video every couple of days, but over the summer they might have a day where they just don't have to do anything and they can binge watch Faze Adapt videos. So, you know, that trend is probably going to be consistent for everybody that we look at here on Twitter or on YouTube. But I'd be willing to bet as we get closer and closer to December, Christmas time, his views will be going back up. So let's just jump over to Faze Rug. I think Faze Rug has maybe a little bit of a different demographic than the other Faze members, and I'd be interested to see what his Twitter is like right now. So Faze Rug's stats are actually pretty similar to Adapt's. He has a little bit less followers on average per day, but they are all positive. There's nothing here that shows anything dying off. If anything, it's actually getting better now that we're moving out of the September month. You know, he gets 1,600 plus followers on average a day, over 1,200 retweets on average per tweet, and over 5,000 likes on average per tweet. So those numbers are a little bit better than Faze Adapt's. Obviously, he gets a little bit more followers on average per day, but overall, they're very similar. They have the same ranking here on Social Blade. They both have a B-. Looking at his YouTube, the same thing is going on here. Moving out of September, his YouTube stats are very similar. Obviously, you know, his total subscribers per day are going up now. Everything is all green. Everything is all good. Actually, October 8th, that Saturday, he got over 33,000 subscribers in that one day, which is absolutely insane. I don't know what happened that day. He obviously uploaded a video that went viral or got a ton of views or something like that. I don't know. Maybe he did a giveaway. I don't know what. I gotta go back and check and see why that happened, but he got a ton of new subscribers that day, which is insane. Looking at his total views per month and his total subs per month, he has again had a pretty steady increase in, you know, viewership and in subscribers. There have been a couple of spikes actually in his total subs per month, but in general it has been an uptrend. And right now, as I predicted, they are down for the past month again. Like I said, that's going to be a trend for all of YouTube, I would suspect. Even in my own channel, I've seen that exact thing, obviously on a much smaller level, but you know, actually, you know what, it's pretty funny. I was, before when summer was in full effect, I was getting about 200 views per video, and in September I was getting about 100 views per video. So you know, that's about half. And as I look here, he got, you know, about, let's see, 47 million monthly views in August and about 30 million views in September, as far as September 1st. So that's not half exactly, but it is a huge chunk. And I know that Faze Adapt's total views per month were actually about half. It went from like 40 to like 22 or something like that. So, you know, that trend is pretty consistent with my channel and with Faze as well, even though there's is a much bigger level. You know, it's a trend across the board that we are going to see amongst everybody, but overall their trend is still upwards. Next, we can look at Faze Rain, another massive Faze clan member. You can look at his followers on Twitter. They are all green. They're all still going up, and they're still getting better as we move into October and you know, like I said, as we move farther into the holiday season, they're probably going to keep going up. His followers per month graph is a straight uptrend. There's no plateauing. There's no dipping off. Everything looks all good as far as his Twitter goes. And looking at his YouTube trends, it's the exact same thing. I mean, we're seeing the numbers kind of bad at the end of September, getting much, much better as we move into October. You know, he hasn't had as much of a little jump as Faze Rug has, but he still gets about 3,000 subscribers on average every single day and about 950,000 video views every single day. And looking at his total views per month for Faze Rain, he again obviously has a peak at the beginning of August with about 50 million views for that month, and right now for September we see he has about 33 million views for that month. And you know, again, like I said, that same drop off occurring once again, but the total trend overall is upwards. This is all upwards. This is all an uptrend, and I don't think there's any long-term, you know, nothing here shows long-term decline. All we're seeing is this one tiny drop because we went from summer into school session, and now that we're moving into October and November, people are going to start getting more hype for the new Call of Duty game. People are going to get hyped for newer games in general, like Battlefield and anything else that's coming out. I know a lot of people are excited for Mafia 3 that just dropped and other things like that, you know. So there's going to be a ton of things popping in the first-person shooter genre as we move forward and closer to Christmas, and then we'll probably see another drop off in January along the, you know, not as massive, I don't think, as the drop off it was for September, but January is generally when people are going back to school, you know, near the end of January or whatever. Some people, you know, like high schoolers and middle schoolers go back to school somewhere in the beginning or middle, or like the first third of January, something like that. I don't remember. I haven't been in high school in so long, but college kids tend to go back to school near the end of January. So, you know, there is going to be a drop off once that all happens again. And finally, let's look at Faze Apex. He's another massive member in the Faze clan, Faze community, whatever. You know, looking at his Twitter statistics, everything is pretty much the same. He is, I guess, a little bit less active on Twitter than the other members that we've seen so far. He gains about 1,300 followers on average per day, and looking at his followers per month, it is a general uptrend, a tiny bit more platformy compared to the other ones that we've seen so far going from September into October, but really not that big of a deal. It's still an uptrend, like, you know, so there's nothing there. You know, if it was a lot more flat, that would be something to be concerned about, but again, even if it was, we're talking about one Faze member that we've looked at out of the four, and again, it's not even the case. So looking at his YouTube, we're seeing the exact same thing, the numbers being a little bit lower for around the 29th, 30th of September, and then increasing from there on out. He gets on average 3,800 subscribers every single day for the past 30 days, and over a million video views, and that's per day in that same time period. Looking at his graph, as far as growth goes, you can see that he actually blew up in a more recently all at once, as opposed to more of a general trend, but still he has been on the solid rise since the beginning of 2015, you know. So I mean, there's nothing here that shows any sort of long-term decline. Again, we do see that exact same thing happening at the beginning of September, where, or the whole month of September rather, where he got 30 million views for that month as opposed to the 45 million views that he got the month prior. Again, this is a consistent trend, meaning that, you know, you're probably going to see this for every single YouTuber that pretty much has the same age bracket demographic. Just for shits and giggles, here's PewDiePie's graph just to prove my point. You can see PewDiePie actually peaked his views a little bit earlier than that. His views were 367 million in July, and then they actually dropped to 280 million views for the month of August, and then they are down to 252 million views for September. So it's actually looking like PewDiePie is on more of a downcline than the Faze members are as far as proportion goes. Obviously, he still has a way bigger fan base. He still gets way more views per month, per day, everything. He's just a much bigger member of the YouTube community, and has just, he's the biggest fucking YouTuber. So there's, you know, no comparing them. But, you know, as far as the amount of views that he gets comparative to, you know, what he got back in the summer of 2014. That was actually when PewDiePie peaked as far as monthly views. Now, I don't know if there was any algorithm changes that had, you know, that happened around there, but the whole point of looking at his you know, charts here is that you're seeing the same drop off in views for PewDiePie as you saw for the Faze members. So that's not a Faze specific thing going on there. Now we can actually look at Colossal's YouTube analytics here on the same website. You know, Social Blade is the go-to for most people, and you can see that he's actually had some really good growth lately. Definitely more of a short-term explosion, I would say, and I would be willing to bet that that is from him being on the Baited podcast with Keemstar and kind of just getting out there, because he only has 9 videos on his channel. So for him to have 222,000 subscribers with only 9 videos is pretty insane. So he's obviously just starting out as far as videos go. Interestingly, you can actually look at his total views per month and his total subs per month, and you can see that short-term explosion that I mentioned before, actually, which is pretty crazy. That dip that we saw on all the other channels is not there for Colossal. It's crazy. And he actually almost doubled. He went up by like a ton. I'm not going to calculate the percent right now because it's really late, but you know, he actually doesn't have that short-term downtrend that a lot of people do have. And again, I think that's because of the timing of the Baited podcast. He's just reaching a much larger audience right now than he has ever before, but he has had a pretty solid uptrend since the beginning of this year. So overall, Colossal is Crazy is a pretty new channel, and I'd say after, you know, he does get as big as he's getting, you know, once he makes this a full-time thing where he's constantly uploading and this is his job, we're going to see more of a steady statistical influx of, you know, subs and views and stuff, and then we'll probably start to see the actual like overall YouTube trends start to apply to his channel. But because this again is more of a newer channel, I would say, I mean, his channel is, you know, he started his channel in like 2014, but you know, as far as just like starting to blow up, it's happening right now. So yeah, so this is a long ass video, and I'm sorry for that. I didn't mean to make it this long, but I kind of just went into it not really knowing exactly what to talk about, and then I, you know, just decided to just show a bunch of analytics of different YouTubers, and we definitely came to the conclusion that Faze is not falling off. Faze is not irrelevant. Faze is surprisingly popular. They're getting bigger. They're becoming more relevant on social media than ever before. And I think Faze actually does social media a lot better than OpTic does. You know, obviously Nadeshot is all over social media, but you know, you have a lot of the OpTic members that just don't really utilize Twitter and Instagram like the Faze members do. They definitely are more about that life, and I think that's showing in their growth. You know, I'd say that they're doing it very, very well, and I don't think Colossal has grounds to say that they are falling off and becoming irrelevant. What he should say is that Call of Duty as a whole and Call of Duty viewership is declining, and you know, that may be true, and that has nothing to do with Faze. You know, them adapting to a different, you know, audience, or to just broadening their audience, broadening their content to apply to more people, that is actually a good thing. You know, it shows that people can actually break out of their shell and break out of the single small demographic that they're in and expand into newer, bigger things on YouTube. That being said, Faze Adapt and those guys still do post Call of Duty content, Call of Duty trick shots and videos and stuff like that. So, you know, they still are pretty much sticking to their roots, but we do, again, obviously see a lot of other things that they do that they are kind of riding trends and just, you know, capturing the trends of the moment. And there's nothing wrong with that. If it keeps them relevant and it keeps them growing, even that is important. If they were riding trends and they were still kind of plateauing, maybe going down a little bit, like, oh, you know, he's obviously only riding the trends to get back, you know, into prominence and becoming relevant again, then he would have grounds to say that. But because they are, you know, using these trends and, you know, incorporating it into the uploads that they normally would do with the trick shotting or, you know, just maybe the live cams of them playing Call of Duty in a free-for-all, they're still uptrending. So I don't see where, you know, Colossal actually thinks that they are becoming irrelevant. Again, like I said, the only grounds that his argument really has is that they have to focus more on other content as opposed to strictly Call of Duty. But I think that again is a trend for YouTube as a whole. We're seeing a lot more people just playing different games in general. You know, people aren't straying too far away from the demographic, you know, like people who come to my channel, they don't mind watching Overwatch content, you know, things like that. And that would not be the case a couple of years ago where people only ever uploaded Call of Duty gameplay, but that is just YouTube changing as it is. Anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you smack a like on this video. I would really appreciate that. You'd be the real homies. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you're new around here and comment down below telling me what you think. You know, do you think Faze is falling off? Is there something that I missed in this video? Is there some analytics that I didn't touch upon or somebody in Faze Clan that I should be looking at for a real model of how the clan is doing? As always, thank you guys so much for watching. This has been OmniArch, and I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.